Assalamu alaikum. I am Nilufar Yasmin. Hello, my dear students. How are you? I hope all of you are fit and fine. Welcome to my online class. Dear students, I am your science teacher. Today, I discuss with you a new chapter. Chapter 11, Force and Simple Machine. So, dear students, please take your science book and open your book, page number 109. Okay, all of you ready to read? To displace an object from one position to another, we need to apply something on it. This something is force. Again, this force is of different types. Moreover, there are various techniques of applying force. By applying this technique, work can be made much easier. Whatever is used to make this force work easily is known as simple machine. You will know about force and simple machines in this chapter. So, dear students, by end of this lesson, we will be able to explain what force is, analyze the effects of different kinds of force on an object, and last one is explain the uses of different types of simple machines. Dear students, do you know what is force? Do you know that we apply force knowingly or unknowingly in various ways in our day-to-day life? You might be thinking, what is this thing called force? Our application of force on different objects in various ways starts from the very morning. We need to apply force in order to open the tap or press the tube handle while getting fresh after getting up from bed. Even we have to apply force in pulling the study chair to sit on. Again, suppose your geometry box is inside the drawer of your reading table. You are to pull and push the drawer respectively to bring it open and close it. You must have switched on light in your room. You have applied force in this instance too. Have you seen anyone to opening a Coke can? This also requires application of force. To kick a football or to strike the cricket ball with bat are examples of applying force. Analyzing the events mentioned above, it will be seen that two things are related with each of them, push and pull. This push and pull are the forces. So, dear students, definition of the force: the position, size, shape, or motion of a body change or tend to change due to the application of force. I repeat it again. The position, size, shape, or motion of a body change or tend to change due to the application of force. Now I discuss with you effect of different types of forces on an object. You must have gotten eraser. Have you seen what changes occur in its shape when it is ever, when it is bended, twisted, pressed, or pulled? The efforts taken to bend, twist, press, and stress involves the application of various forms of force on a certain object. Will you be able to draw the diagrams illustrating this? So, dear students, you can see some of picture eraser efforts. You can see effect of force on an object. So, observe another interesting event. Have you ever played with marble? At first, the marbles are kept scattered in front of you. Then target on of the marble from the scattered ones to strike it by another marble from a short distance. When you throw the marble off, your hand to the target. What do you see? When the marble strikes the target, you will see that the marble changes its state of rest to the state of motion after receiving the strike. You might also see this marble striking another marble at rest. Even this process may continue for a while. This process will continue till any force is not applied on the marble in motion. In addition to that, it is observed that the frictional force of ground stops the marble at a certain time. Let us give another example. It may happen that a microbus go out of order on the road. Then it may be required to push the microbus to run. It may not move it, only one person pushes it. When 4 to 5 persons push it together, it may start to move, even run. Here, force has been applied. As a result, the body at rest changes or tries to change the state of rest. Now, will you be able to tell what are the events that have happened here? Different changes in motion have happened due to application of force on the marble. Similarly, general force can be applied to change a body at rest to a state of motion, to increase or decrease the motion of a body in motion, and to stop a moving body completely. From the above examples, we come to the conclusion mentioned below. When force is applied on a body changes its state from rest to motion and motion to rest. The speed of a body in motion can be increased or decreased. The direction of the motion of a body is changed. The size, shape, or volume of a body are changed. Accordingly, we can say that force is the thing that, when applied on a body at rest, changes or tries to change the state of rest to motion, or when applied on a body in motion, changes or tries to change its state of motion to rest, or changes the shape and size of that. The uses of force is seen in numerous activities, such as putting an electric switch off or on, opening a coke can, crushing spices, lifting weight, throwing stones, drawing boards, wandering, click the mouse of computer, etc. The application of force is seen even in using things, starting from motor car, train, airplane, pushcart to rickshaw pedals. Dear students, now I discuss with you simple machine. You must have seen the process of lifting or shifting a heavy body by applying force at one end of a long iron or wooden pole, leaning against a piece of stone or brick on the other end. Yes, it becomes easier to a great extent to move away a heavy body by using the iron or wooden rod in this special method. Easily you can experience doing this in your classroom. In this event of doing a work using iron or wooden rod leaning against a stone, the setup has acted like a simple machine. Basically, it has made it possible to do more work by applying less force. In this way, we use different simple machines to make jobs easier in our daily life. Examples of such simple machines include scissors, forceps, hammer, crowbar, pulley, lever, etc. The common characteristics of these machines is a special technique is applied on them to make work easier. The simple machines mentioned above can make work easier in one or more than one way mentioned below. It can be done by multiplying the applied force by many times. performing a work applying less force. Applying force in one advantageous direction. Performing work in a particular way which would be difficult to do otherwise. Increases motion and speed. Here one thing is to be noted that in doing work by all the machines, an externally imposed force is required. Now, you will be familiar with various simple machines separately and will be able to explain how mechanical efficiency is obtained from them. So, dear students, no more today. Next class, I discuss with you labor, the classification of labor. Hammer, forceps, and inclined plane and pulley. So, dear students, please read the lesson properly. At least you read the lesson at least 3 times. Then you can give the answer. Any questions? Okay, please note down to do some work. Make 15 MCQ from chapter 11, lesson 1 to 3. So, dear students, I hope you have finished your writing. If you have any inquiry, please contact with me. Thank you. Goodbye.